This is another edition of Chat and Chew with Coach Trae, and I am here with the amazing Ashland Anderson and our pretzels that we have. I don't know why we chose pretzels to use for this, because I'm going to get dry mouth and can't talk. Ashland probably is going to sit here and just eat the entire time, so I don't know what's going to happen. So, the plan today is to get to know Ashland and also to see her dance a little bit so you guys can get a sneak peek behind the scenes of what we do here at ACA. And Ashland, tell us about yourself. Who are you? What's the deal? Who is Ashland?
Well, my name is Ashland Anderson. I do a lot of facials because I was in cheerleading at school. I'm in seventh grade and I do cheerleading, drama, speech and debate, so I'm very dramatic. And I just do a lot of activities at school, and I'm about to go into sports, and I'm 13 years old.
So, she mentioned that she's very dramatic, and she does a lot of facials. So, she is our facial queen on our Blue Flames team, which is our majorette dance line style team that we have under ACA Dance Company. And nobody can kill this girl when it comes to her facials and her expressions, because she is so freaking dramatic. So, I know you mentioned that you do a lot on campus. So how does that really work with being able to do all of that at school and come here? Because Ashland takes probably out of all of the Dance Company girls, you take a lot of classes, right?
Yes.
What classes are you taking, or were you taking during the season before we got out?
I was in language arts.
Girl, I'm not talking about your school. I'm talking about
what
your classes
mean,
here.
Classes?
Your classes here. Your dance
you just
classes.
Said classes. So I thought it was still on school. Okay, so for the classes I used to take, it was a list. I used to do company rehearsal. I used to do the teen adult class. I'm naming things from this time. Okay.
So let's see. You were in ballet, company
yes.
ballet. Yeah. Miss Stormy, you had modern, jazz.
Mm-hmm.
You were in pompology. What else? I feel like there was another class you were in.
I was in company, but then.
What company rehearsal? Anyway, so it was probably like 5 hours that you were here.
Yes.
During the week, just training and doing everything on top of what you had to do at school. And then you're like really, 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 really active in theater. So you had some lead roles. What are some things that you did at school with your plays and things?
So at school for my speech and debate team, we go to competition. Now when we go to competition, we go to high schools to compete against high schoolers and middle schoolers, and I have to go against the high schoolers. So like we do different pieces, and I have to perform seven different original pieces, and then we also do plays. And for plays, I normally get the lead role. I played Jan and Owe Etengo Webb, and I played Emerald for Seven Nasty Princesses.
Okay. So, a little bit about Ashland. Ashland was able to go to our Starbound competition this past season, right? And we took her in and doing one of her theatrical pieces where she had to do a monologue. And if I remember correctly, what place did you place?
I placed third place.
Third place in a dance competition, right?
Yeah.
So that means she went into a dance competition acting and beat out dancers, coming in third place overall in her category. In that division. That was like the teen division or something like that. And we had other dancers from ACA that were in that same category that placed like fourth or something. Or were they in the same category as you?
Yes.
Yeah. And then you placed over them, I thought. Yeah, you did. So that was really, really amazing. So Ashland just has been a force to be reckoned with since she came here. Since day one, Ashland came in into auditions her first season. And we all remember this story because she came in with 104 fever and still came to auditions. She refused to not audition. So what was that like? What was going through your head when you were that sick and you had auditions and you didn't want to miss it?
So when I was at school, when I recently got sick, my mom was like, okay, so I don't think you could do the auditions. And I was like, wait, are you crazy? I was like, this is my opportunity to be on the team. I was like, what if I can't get this opportunity again? I was like, I'm going to go in there if I had a broken leg, and then I will try my best to show that I put effort into what I was doing. So then maybe that will be good enough, even if my performance wasn't good on that day for me being sick, that they could see how much I wanted to be on the team.
And it really showed, because actually I was the only person there that knew she was sick. None of the girls knew she was sick. None of the judges knew she was sick until the very end, when we were selecting the girls for the team and we were kind of going through everything. And I then told the judges, and they were like, what? She was sick? I said, yep, 104 fever. Shouldn't have been here. Probably would have passed out if she wasn't just fighting through it. So they couldn't even believe it. And then this year's auditions, you had a performance, right?
Yes.
So you ended up coming late, like, seriously late. We have generally a couple different sessions that we do, and you came in during which session?
I came in the majorette.
So you came in during majorette, and what was that like, walking in? And we had Kenya Clay, who was a former TSU motion dancer, who was teaching that set for us. So tell me what that was like, coming in and you were late and didn't know what was going on and had to jump right into it.
Okay, so when I first walked in the door, I was like, oh, they're learning this already? And I was like, okay, you're awesome, you're amazing. Like, trying to say things from my head, like, to tell myself that I could do it, even though if I came in late. And I was saying how I don't care who else know the choreography, I'm gonna make sure that I learn it. And I wanted her to go over it again at least one more time so I could, like, stick it in my brain and, like, go to the sidelines and see what I could do. And the moves were very challenging, but I was trying to, like, tell myself that I could do it. Like, if I could do this, then I could do anything throughout this season.
And she did. Let me tell you, this girl came in, like, the last 5-8 counts of the routine. It was a pretty lengthy piece that she had done. And came in and learned the last couple 8 counts and literally slayed everybody in the room with the highest score in that in that entire category for that majorette set. So again, the girl is awesome, and you guys are going to get to see that here in a few minutes with her little bit of kind of catch-ons, 8 counts and things that she's going to do for you guys, just kind of give you like a little studio moment with her. So if there is anything that you could tell someone out there that's looking at you right now about kind of progressing past what people kind of see and being the best that you can be, because you do kind of display that all the time, what encouragement can you give to another girl or young man or whomever that may be needing that kind of encouragement to kind of push past all of the struggles that they may be going through to come in and still be freaking awesome, like Ashland awesome, like that deal. What would you tell them? Like, what could you put into their head to kind of chant to themselves every day to get past?
So, first off, I don't think that I'm all that every day, because when I first came, I only know cheer things, and I was like, oh my goodness, like, and that my favorite dancer was Ariana at that moment, and she's probably still one of my favorite dancers. Like, I liked how she did her V layout, like, effortlessly, and I was like, man. And then I had the opportunity for her to teach me, and then that was, like, cool too, and I was, like, really freaking out, because I thought that she was, like, the best dancer at the moment. So I just want to tell you that I'm up there where she is, and she's like she's an original flame, and I think that's cool that I could be like on the same team as her. So I didn't even know what like a V layout was, extension. I didn't know none of those things, and I just came in and I had to learn, and it was like a process that I had to deal with, because like when I walked in the door, I didn't know anything. Like how to do a toe touch, and I was probably a cheer toe touch. Like there was different things to what I know and different meanings behind it. So when I came in here, I didn't know nothing about majorette. I know nothing about booking. Like I do know the dancing laws, but you could do anything that you're capable of. You could do anything that you see on TV. It just puts effort into it. Like you're not gonna think that you could do it at first, but then when it's over, it'd be worth your while. Because now I get kip up.
Yeah, you do have your kip up now. So, I hope everybody is ready to see her throw some moves. You ready?
Yeah.
All right, well, let's get into it.
Day, I know that I can count on you. When that's not possible, tell me, can you weather the storm? Just of you, oh. Girl, to make it last, I'll do whatever.